nigga, I turn nothing into something. My hand was in that pot, I was trying to make something. Oh yeah, these niggas be fake, so I'm watching these niggas. Clutching my pistol, trying to slide on me, then I'm gon' kill them. I'm not trying to kick it, niggas be fake.
Yo, 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 yo. I said, yo. What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Jeremy's coming at you guys with another video. Now, today, before I even get into the video, smash the like button if you're a fan of Derrick Rose or you know how Derrick Rose used to play. Smash the like button if you support the channel. Smash the like button if you're gonna make this video. Subscribe to the channel. That's the most important thing, guys. Make sure that you subscribe to the channel. And when you hit that subscribe button, be sure to hit the notification bell so whenever I upload a new video, which is every day, you guys can get notified. Into today's video now, we got this point guard build for you, Derrick Rose build. Now, usually when other YouTubers or just me too make a video about a build, I usually only show you guys the first, like, the first option, but I'm going to show you the two different options. Now, this build right here, the pure slasher, it has playmaking in it. Well, it has really good slashing in it, but the playmaking is pretty much down. So it's either between the pure slasher build or between the one that has like about a 91 driving dunk and a 92 ball control. I'm going to show you guys the two comparisons in the two, like the two different ones, just so you guys can see. This one right here is kind of, I mean, like, the thing about it, guys, this here, if you have an 86 ball control, it's not recommended. Even Mike Wang, one of the devs, recommended that it's not worth it to go with the 86 ball control if you're looking at a speed boost, because if you get cold or you have a couple of bad shots, your stats do start to decrease, so you won't be able to speed boost as consistently as someone who has like a 92 ball control or a 91 ball control. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to upgrade this one right here, the one that has the pure slasher in it. Like, it's not a pure slasher, but it has like the best dunking for a guard in it. Obviously, if you have a Derrick Rose build, guys, you want to go with everything in the paint maxed out, because Derrick Rose was that good in the paint. Now, some people are going to be like, you don't need post hooks, but bro, when you put that up, you get more upgrades for that category. So that means more Hall of Fame badges, more gold badges, or however you want to upgrade them. But mainly, if you do want to go with this one, you will get 30 Hall of Fame finishing. Well, not 30 Hall of Fame, but 30 upgrades. 4 upgrades cost you a Hall of Fame badge, and 3 upgrades cost you a gold badge. And you guys know the order after that. But yeah, so far, I have an 86 ball control, and the dunking is a 95. But the three-point shooting, I think that's what makes this build so bad. The shooting is so bad that it just... to me, it isn't worth making. If you're trying to replicate a D Rose build, it is not worth making this build, because the shooting is just so bad. Like, D Rose wasn't the best of shooters, but he definitely wasn't a bad three-point shooter. He was an average three-point shooter, and he had a decent, like a good enough mid-range game, so he could actually make the mid-range shot consistently a lot, actually. So to have it at this, that's what makes this build not the replication of Derrick Rose that you want it to be. Now, you see right here, when I put the wingspan down, you do get a 90 ball control, but at the same time, Derrick Rose is also known for being really fast with the ball, so you kind of want to be searching for the build that has the most speed in it possible and the best finishing. That combination right there is going to definitely help you out. Now, for the height, I'm just going to say it right now, I'm going to keep it at 6'3 because Derrick Rose was 6'3, but you can play around with the weight. We don't have to sit here and mess around with the weight or whatever and try to, because you can't replicate any builds in it. You can make them depending on how their stats were, but you can't fully replicate that build, because they're always going to be able to do more as an NBA player, and in play now, they'll always be better than the players that we create. But that's perfectly fine. We got to have some kind of balance. We can't have demi guys running around the whole damn place, because if that was the case, everybody would make a Giannis player. So now I'm going to go to this one. This is the one that I would choose, honestly. I would choose this one right here simply because you get more playmaking and you're still extremely athletic. So that's why I went with this one right here. And you still get to unlock contact dunks at an 85. This one goes to an 89. That's perfectly fine because, I mean, he was getting contact dunks, but his finishing was also another thing that was just really good. And you see right here, you only get 5 less upgrades compared to the other one, and you get 6 more playmaking upgrades, which is pretty good because that'll just help you be a lot faster with the ball. and you'll have a lot more options when driving to the rim. You see on this one right here, you get a 92 ball control, but obviously when I fix the wingspan and things like that, you'll see it goes up to about a 95. Defense, obviously you guys want to put that distill up, the lateral quickness up, and the perimeter defense up. You don't want to be out there just like not trying to defend at all. Not a weight, you can put it to about 184 as long as you have that that acceleration. That's the main thing you really want. You want the speed to be really high, just about the same as the acceleration. So if you get that, you're perfectly fine. But you see right here, you end up getting a 95 ball control and a 77 mid-ranger. I feel like that's the most important thing. You want to be able to at least shoot the mid-ranger with this D-Rose build. And then if you're open for the three, then maybe if you have the correct badges or so, maybe, I forgot how much it is, you'll be able to make a couple jump shots. But like I said, guys, you see me playing around with the wingspan right here. It's up to you at the end of the day. Either or, you're going to be able to dunk really well. But on this one, you have a better jump shot. So, I mean, how do you guys want to play? Do you want to go out there with a slasher that just has no ability to shoot at all? That would be signing yourself up just to get handicapped, and it literally would not be worth it. Now, obviously, if you were going to pick this build, you would go with the slashing. That shouldn't even be up for debate. You would have to go with the slashing. Or if you don't care about that, then you go with the playmaking. If you want the speed, break ankles, and then go to the basket, that's up to you. But I highly recommend you go with the slashing badge. Now, I'll look over it again because I know some people are going to be like, oh, well, if you upgrade this, you upgrade that. I'm going through it very thoroughly so you guys can see. Like, there's not really much you can do with it. It's up for debate because I know some people are going to say, like, oh, well, bro, like, you know, maybe if you go with this one, you still get good playmaking badges. And then D-Rose, he's just a really good finisher. But then again, like I said, anybody that challenges for that, my response to that would simply be, this build just can't shoot that well. This build is for, like, I'm trying to think of a player. Honestly, with the season that Westbrook just had from the three-point line, this would be a good Westbrook build. Now, I know if you guys know the YouTuber by the name of Joe Knows, really popular YouTuber, like, almost 400k subs. He made a Derrick Rose build video. He made a Westbrook build video, and he made it the other one too that I end up choosing. And the reason he went with it, he said, was because Westbrook could actually shoot. But I mean, if you look at, he said he's a decent shooter, like he's a below average shooter. But this season, he shot like 29% from the 3-point line. That's really terrible. So just for his terrible shooting and his terrible playoff performance, this is especially catered to Westbrook right here. This bill, Westbrook can have this bill right here, man, because ain't nobody trying to not be able to shoot. I don't know about y'all, but I definitely want to be able to shoot. I don't care if I'm making a slasher. I don't care what I'm making. The one thing I will not do is I will not handicap myself. That's just out the picture. So, yeah, I'm just going through everything for you guys. So, for the people that might be a little bit confused about it, like, what about if you do this? What about if you do that? This one right here, the physicals, is really debatable, because if you really want to go with the wing, like the vertical being like a 90, you can go with that too. If you want to jump really high just to lose a little, just only to lose like a little bit of speed and a little bit of acceleration just to get that extra vertical. So when you go up in the paint, you could jump a little bit higher, or when you're going to help get rebounds. But honestly, on this build, you're not really going to be upgrading the rebound at all. Like, literally at all, you won't be upgrading the rebounding. So, yeah, you shouldn't even have to worry about it at all. I'm not going to lie to you. There's really no worry for it, simply because you have only one upgrade for defense anyways. Because with this build, you have to put everything maxed out in the finishing, or you won't be able to get that full D-Rose experience. That's why I said it's just important to max out the obvious things like perimeter defense, your steal, your lateral quickness. Those three things are just the main things you have to upgrade. And then once you upgrade everything else, you pretty much get the same exact player as D-Rose. Just that, the shooting, like I said, guys, that's one of the only things you cannot replicate. You really can't replicate the shooting, because some of these players have a decent jump shot. Like Derrick Rose, his three-pointer would be like maybe like a 73. If we're talking about like a real Derrick Rose player, about a 73 to 75 three-pointer. And that would be like the right D-Rose build. But as you can see right here in this build, they're not giving it to us, bro. They're not gonna be that generous. 2K's not gonna be that generous. They're like, nah, if you wanna shoot, you better go make you a slashing sharpshooter or something like that. We ain't giving you the chance to do that. That's perfectly fine though. I'm not tripping over it. Like I said right here, guys, the body shape, this literally does nothing to you. Like, it doesn't matter what body shape you pick, it has no effect on your stats or nothing like that. So don't worry about it. It's just how you want your player to look. Honestly, in the past, yes, it did affect you, But I felt like, I feel like 2K probably was like, you know what, that's not even really something that we should really let affect them. It just depends on how they upgrade their player or whatever. Because if you guys think about it, if you play sports in real life, you know, some, even some of the skinny people, you think they're not strong, but when you try to box them out or you get down in the paint with them, you see how strong they actually are. So I like the fact that 2K actually did this. You can pick whatever body type you want, and your players still can end up being strong. But you see right here, I was playing around with the weight, and I found that perfect weight about 184, 185. This is the perfect weight because you get that extra, just the extra boost of vertical. Why not? You want to try to just get the best out of your player possible. So yeah, and this right here, this shouldn't even be debatable right here. You got to definitely put the wingspan all the way down. You literally get better ball handling and better post moves. It'll just help you get more badges, whatever. Be better in the paint, and you get a better shot. Now, obviously, like I said, guys, going on to the badge right here. I picked Slasher. I highly recommend you pick Slasher too. And you guys see right there, you get Derrick Rose. The first build that popped up was Derrick Rose. And that's perfect right there. That's literally perfect. I couldn't have made it any better. Simply because, guys, like I said, the playmaking is what really made Derrick Rose also good. Like, he was fast as hell with the ball. Like, the way how he got to the rack, it just literally amazed you every time you watched him. But yeah, this tester right here, you want to have it at a 99, simply because this year you can upgrade your player however you want to. So you don't got to worry about 2K saying, oh, you got to wait till you hit 97 to get a 95 ball control. Nah, it doesn't work like that this year. You upgrade the player as you please, how you please. So day one, if you get 10 upgrades, you can upgrade your three-pointer all the way, your dunk, whatever you want to upgrade. It's up to you. So don't worry about that, guys. In the beginning of the demo, a lot of people were like, oh, I'm going to test it out at 85, because that's what it's like day one. But how long do you really stay on at 85? And half the time, a lot of people go to my career to fix it anyways. But we're going to fix the badges. And once I fix the badges, I'm going to come right back to y'all. Actually, I already did this. It's pre-recorded, so I know what I did. But boom, y'all see the badges we get. We get 6 Hall of Fame, 6 finishing. So that's 12 Hall of Fame badges. We get about 3 gold badges, and then like 2 bronze badges. So yeah, it's pretty OP. I'm gonna go through each and every badge and tell you guys why I picked those specific badges, so you can understand where I'm coming from. Now, D-Rose, Acrobat, Spin, Half Spin, Hop Step, Euro Step, Cradle, Reverse, and Chain Shot Layup Attempts receive a significant boost. So anytime you do a hop step, a Euro, which is how D-Rose played in real life, you get a boost. So doing those flashy moves in the paint is actually gonna help you out more than it'll hurt you. For somebody like my player, 2-way, 3-level facilitator, I'm not gonna be, I didn't put Acrobat on at all, because I'm not trying to come in the paint and do anything flashy. I'm trying to keep it simple, because I'm not a slasher. If I wanted to do slashing, I would have made it, bro. But contact finisher is another one that shouldn't even be up for debate. D-Rose was not afraid of contact. He would drive on the biggest centers, dunk on people, everything in the book you could think of, this is what he did. And especially the layups too, he lived for those. Fast break finisher, you also have to have that on Hall of Fame, because this man was just unreal in transition. That's where he got a lot of his points from, in transition, because how quick he was. He would push the ball, a giant slayer. This is another thing that just should be on your player, because as a finisher, you want this badge, because especially if you're a point guard and you're undersized, like 6'3 is considered undersized in 2K, so you want that badge. Relentless finisher is going to help you continuously go back to the paint. That's what it says. That's what Mike Wayne tweeted. It improves the ability to take whatever, you guys see what it says. Incendiary finisher increases a player's ability to slide through traffic and avoid contact during gathers and finishes at the rim. So slithery finisher is going to make you be a versatile finisher when you're going to the paint. You won't get as much contact as someone who doesn't have slithery finisher, so it'll help you avoid that contact. You'll finish a lot easier. And teardropper, gotta have that on bronze, because D-Rose could make teardroppers. Some people might debate that you gotta have teardropper higher, but realistically, in game, no one really uses teardropper that much. That's why I'm messing around with it right here. A lot of people are gonna be like, yo, bro, it's Derrick Rose, he was also good at teardropping. But come on now, did he do teardropper every single play? I feel like all that was much more his bread and butter. But volume shooter, I'm not really sure if it activates for layups. I think it might only activate for shot attempt, like jump shots. I'm not 100% sure on that. But when I was playing in game, I already recorded a gameplay for this. I didn't see a ton of, like, I didn't see volume shooter pop up that much. So if you guys want to switch it around and put something else on, you can. But difficult shots is the right thing to put on also. Ankle breaker. If you guys don't know, there's a throwback video I want you guys to go look at. Derrick Rose breaks Tyreek Evans' ankles. That was one of the most craziest ankle breakers I've seen. Derrick Rose is coming down the lane in transition, and he just hit one of the meanest crossovers, like going full speed, and like Tyreek Evans just couldn't handle it, and his legs just gave out. That was like a legitimate ankle breaker. That was one of the best ankle breakers I've ever seen. So yeah, you need that dimer. He averaged like 7 assists, so yeah, definitely give this to him. Downhill gives a bonus to a player's speed with ball attribute in fast break situations. So yeah, like I said, Derrick Rose lived in the fast break in transition. So that's why you want to give him this badge, because it'll only help you when you're going down the lane in transition. And as a slasher, you should want this. Like, you shouldn't want the defense to put you in like a half court set. You should want to go like full speed, push the ball, get some easy layups, because it's a little bit more difficult to drive when everyone's focused on you driving. So yeah, handles for days. Also, this is another thing you want to have. It's D Rose. He was able to handle the ball really well. Actually had really good ball control. So yeah, it makes sense. And quick first step. This shouldn't even be up for debate. This is like a blow-by badge, really. I don't know why 2K added this, but they did. It is what it is. I'm going to have it on my player on gold. I need it. Like, it's mandatory for me personally. It literally helps you just boost off. If you do a jab step and you dribble, it just, everything is just like a takeoff. So this is a badge that you need to have. Stop and go. This helps you in transition. So, like, you can kind of catch defenders with this when you're driving or when you're pushing the ball in transition. If you click L2, it makes you do like a stutter step. And if you dribble out of that, that'll be considered a stop and go. Or simply, if you just come on the court behind the back and then go again, that should activate it. Tight handles also. It just makes it easier for you to get past your defender. Simple. Makes it easier for you to get past your defender. And you need this if you're a slasher. Like, why wouldn't you want this? You're trying to get to the paint really easily. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this Derrick Rose build video. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to smash the like button. Drop your comments down below. Which one of these would you choose? Would you choose the one that I made, or would you choose the other one that has more slashing in it? And then just go ahead with the 90 ball control. Either or would be pretty decent. But just know that if you make the pure slasher one, kind of, you won't be able to shoot at all. So you'll really be handicapping yourself. But like I said, that's not up for me to decide. It's up to you how you guys want to play. Just for the sake of this video, I'm going to use the Derrick Rose jump shot. I don't think when I did the gameplay, I don't think I took one jump shot. But hey, since it's a Derrick Rose build, if you're really a hardcore fan of him and you want to make that same player build, then go ahead and put on the Derrick Rose jump shot. Just know that he does already have a slow jump shot. So yeah, you won't be making any jumpers. But yeah, you guys see what it says on my player right there. It says subscribe to JR Rank. So do your boy a favor. Hit that subscribe button, leave a like on this video, and when you hit the subscribe button, be sure to hit the notification bell. We're coming with videos every single day, bro. Like, this grind I'm going on for 2K20 is gonna be unreal. I hope you guys get to join, and well, I hope you guys do join so y'all can see the crazy journey that we're about to be on. But yeah, the game comes out September 6th. I can't wait. I know y'all can't wait. In the meantime, let's keep liking up these videos and subscribing to the channel if you're new. It's your boy John Ranks, and I'm out. I'm not tryna kick it, niggas be fake, so I'm keeping my distance. That shit turned to a habit, you don't really know the feeling. No, you don't. You don't really know the feeling. No, you don't. You don't really know the feeling. No, you don't.